You're certainly welcome to them. Well, one of them anyway. I hold the key that will open one cage and cause the other to plummet into the infinity vortex. Now the question is, which of the X-Men did you wish me to save? The pious Nightcrawler or the benevolent Jean Grey? I should have guessed you'd detect such foolishness.
I have no objections.
Will do.
Stay back. Do not unlock this door. Nightcrawler's cage would fall. I refuse to be the cause of his death. He's a good man, and he deserves to live.
Nine, do not open this door. It will cause Jean's cage to fall. Please, if you have any mercy in your heart, do not doom me to a life of guilt. Save Jean. It needs for me to perish.
Believe it. Kurt's dead.
I know. I don't blame you. It was an impossible choice. Come on. I've got a score to settle with Mephisto.
Noted. You're to return to home base immediately.
Professor, maybe you don't realize it, but Kurt just died.
And that is precisely why you are to return. In your present state, you are a liability to the team.
But, Professor, don't you? Very well. If you say so.
Now is not the time for remorse. Make Kurt's death mean something. Stop the Master's evil before any more lives are lost.
Now you feel the pain of the alternate loss. And no doubt, you seek revenge. Come then. And face me! I will show you an entirely new world of pain when I rip your astral spirit from your body. At last, the heroes have arrived. But then, I would have waited an eternity to possess you. Indeed you are. So much so that I gave Dr. Doom the Twilight Sword in exchange for leading you into my domain. He has rather unique plans for Asgard. The resourceful doctor stands a very good chance of succeeding. But enough of Doom. My wait is over, and now my minions will take your astral spirits.
Thank you.
anchor.
X-Man's astral energy that resonates in my dimension. And that is more than enough for me to reconstruct your friend. But before I grant you this favor, You must prove yourself worthy by solving the puzzle. Prepare yourselves.
As you wish.
I'm alive.
I do hate to ruin this happy moment, but I failed to mention one slight detail. This echo of your friend is all too easy for me to control. Isn't that right, Nightcrawler?
That is correct, Lord Mephisto.
Now, destroy your friends so that I might take their astral energy.
As you wish, my lord.
Oh.
sorry for attacking you. I hate to disappoint you, but Mephisto spoke the truth. I am but an echo of my real self. I cannot leave this realm. As I said, I cannot leave here. And we must face facts. You cannot defeat Mephisto. But I can. By sacrificing what little energy I have left, there is nothing that can be done for me. And I would rather die honorably than spend an eternity damned in this place. Take care, mein Freunds. And may God watch over you. Now prepare yourself, Mephisto. For you are about to face the might of the amazing Nightcrawler.
Stay back from me! I command you, stay back!
Yes, he did. Kurt couldn't leave that realm, and he was the only one who could defeat Mephisto. There were no other options. Now is not the time for sorrow. My friend gave his life to save you and to aid you in your mission. Go. Stop the Masters of Evil. Do not allow them to achieve success. And Kurt Wagner will not have died in vain.
Team, I hate to even bring this up, but Mephisto did mention Dr. Doom had plans for Asgard. Return to base as quickly as possible so that we can respond to this new threat.
I concur.
The loss of Nightcrawler is a tragedy. No one believed more deeply in the X-Men's struggle to promote understanding between mutants and humans. And while we may miss Kurt as a friend, the world is going to miss him as the rarest type of champion there is. A champion of peace. I wish there was additional time to mourn Nightcrawler's death. But from what was heard in Mephisto's realm, we have to get to Asgard quickly. To go to Asgard, use the Orb of Teleportation.